Dark mode is amazing. It's the best thing that happened to web design since the removal of the blink tag. And while it might or might not be better for your eyes, battery life and the environment, the most important thing is that it just looks so good. Wow. Manually implementing it is often a time-intensive process, and even some big websites still miss this essential feature. But it doesn't have to be that way. What if I told you there's a way to add dark mode to your own website by just adding a single line of code? Manually adding dark mode to a website is essentially specifying all colors of text and backgrounds a second time, but inverted. CSS frameworks like Tailwind make it easier by allowing you to specify rules directly on the HTML element that will only be applied if your operating system is set to dark mode. You can also use CSS variables to speed up the process. But what you end up doing is basically just inverting all colors. Black text turns white, and white background turns black. If you're really fancy, you can use some shaded gray instead. But that's not rocket science. This should be easy. There's no way this cannot be automated. CSS cannot only be used to set text and background colors. There are a lot of weird features in there that nobody really uses, except for when programming teachers run out of ideas for your programming homework. One of them are CSS blend modes. Applying them to any element will make everything behind the element look like you just entered the peak of your LSD trip. But we can use them to invert the colors of our entire page by setting it to blend mode difference and just overlapping our entire site. This works great, but only as long as we don't have any images or icons on the site. So basically never. Searching for a solution that provides more flexibility, I stumbled upon an approach published by Aral Balkan that I will use to build my own micro framework for adding dark mode to websites automatically. It uses a very similar, rarely used CSS feature called CSS filters. Using CSS filters, we can invert the colors of any element of our website. Unfortunately, this will not only turn black to white, but invert all of our colors, which is not what we want for a dark mode. To keep the colors somewhat consistent with the light mode, we'll use Hue Rotate, which is another CSS filter that changes only the hue of an element, without changing the lightness or saturation. Rotating it by 180 degrees makes sure that we end up with the same hue that we started with. Now, if we apply those two filters to the body of our website, we already get a much nicer version than before, but images and icons still look like garbage. But here's the deal. If we just apply the same CSS filters again to our images, they will look like nothing ever happened. This might sound like a hack, but it's actually a feature. A feature that you can use with the Nightowl micro framework by just adding the Nightowl Daylight class to any HTML element. But for images, it's applied automatically already. To set dark mode correctly, we can use the Prefers Color Scheme CSS feature to detect if a browser or operating system is running in dark mode. Depending on the preference, we'll apply our dark mode CSS filters when a user loads the page. To change the preference, Nightowl includes a small button overlay which toggles between light and dark mode and saves the preference in the local storage, so it stays the same when the user next visits the page. Of course, this approach comes with a few caveats, most notably inconsistencies when using position fixed inside of your website. Because the way we use CSS filters on the body resets the context for all elements inside of it. Also, contrasts are not guaranteed to work in the dark version. But for most simple websites, this approach should work just fine, and it's an easy and quick way to add dark mode to websites that would otherwise probably never get dark mode at all. In the future, I plan to add more utility classes for fixing contrast issues after the colors have been inverted, and better ways to handle box shadows, as white shadows on black background honestly just look like garbage. If you want to try it out on your website, all you need to do is embed darkhole.js with a single line of code. Just make sure to test it properly and fix the minor version, as it is still in the prototyping stage and the API may change at any point. If you run into any problems, please open an issue on the GitHub repository instead of committing a hate crime in the comment section of this video. You can find more details about the integration in the GitHub repository that is linked in the description down below. And while you're down there, make sure to leave a like if you enjoyed the video and subscribe for more content like this. See you in the next one.